So welcome dear learners, welcome in the SWAYAM MOOCs. First of all, thanks for enrolling in our MOOC. So as you have already enrolled in our SWAYAM MOOCs, we are here with this video to address your most of the queries, general queries, and with some FAQs. First of all, first thing is regarding the access, course access. You can access our course or any SWAYAM MOOCs from PC, from laptop, from your browsers, using the browsers, or through your mobile phones or using the Android app, SWAYAM app. Just a little bit issue with the SWAYAM app is that the location of a particular lesson may be different as compared to the desktop version if you are using the desktop or laptop. Say for example, in the academic writing course also you might have seen that the week graded quiz in SWAYAM app is the top, while in the actually in the course page it is the at the last of the week. Okay, so no issue. And I would like to clarify that the course videos are not going to be delivered in the emails. Many learners ask that we haven't got in the email. No, you will have to go to the course page and access the course from the SWAYAM portal. The next thing is, these videos are not live. These are the recorded videos. So please don't get confused. Now, directly we will be moving and addressing the access steps of the SWAYAM portal and accessing your course in the SWAYAM. So as you can see, this is our SWAYAM portal. What you have to do, you will have to register or sign in. After registration, you will be sign in through your the same email ID which you have used for your registration of yourself in the course. Say for example, as a learner, we are showing here how you can access the course. This is the, yes, this is the learner's ID. I'm using that through the Google. You can also, if you have opted it, you might have used, you can also use that Facebook or other sources. Now this is the, at the top right corner, my profile, my courses. You can go to the my courses here. When this is the course you have enrolled. If you have enrolled in the multiple courses, other courses will also appear here. Now go to course. Here in academic writing, I have clicked go to course here. Then the course page will be open. Net is a little bit slow. Now this is the course page. Yeah, as you can see in the left navigation bar, first of all, this is the details about the course, the objectives, and then the warm-up activities. If this prior activities are there in our course, we have done some warm-up activities in the live webinar which are available in this warm-up activity session, pre-activity session. So week one has already been released. So you will have the introductory video, and one module is divided into the three chunks, three parts. So say for example, module one, part one, if you open, we will have the about 10 minute video of module one, that is, and after that you will get this you will get the e-content of this portion also. Right now the link is not there, but you will be getting it. Yeah, it's a server down is there a little bit, so no issue. What is the web page is there, so you can use this in the course page. In the meanwhile, you can go to the self-assessment part. Like in the self-assessment, it is the daily quizzes which we have offered to you for checking your knowledge, what you have gained. Each question is having 0 points, so don't get confused because you are not going to be given any marks for these things. So when you have opted it, you can click the check answer, you will get the answers here. Okay, so you can confirm whether you have done right or wrong. So that's why, because they are self-assessment exercise, that's why there is no submit button here. Where you will get the submit button? In the week graded quizzes or these assignments. The same kind of quiz will be there, but the difference is you will get the submit button here. Because you can see that the assignment not submitted so far here, the last day due date is there, and after the due date only you will get the feedback here. Okay, so there is no check answer button, so don't get confused. There will be only submit answers button. You will submit the answers, and by this way you can submit your assignment. Okay, now after having this schedule or the outline, what is needed more, that the graded quiz announcement, you need to know about that. What is the announcement? In the announcement page you will get the announcement from the admin, from our course team. So you will be getting the announcement with the footer or header, like we have mentioned here, team AW or whatever the course will be there. So course identification will be there in each announcement, which you will also be getting in your email. So regularly check your email for the updates. Okay, so these are the announcement by the course admin. Next most important quadrant is ask a question. This is the ask a question is a discussion forum. Here you can discuss with your fellow learners, and you can put your questions in the forum from the admin and the learners. The subject matter expert will be there, and our teaching assist team will be there to answer your queries. So you can also help other fellow learners. So you can click if you are any problem with that, any queries there, you can put there. And before asking any question, please go through the discussion forum. You might be having your same question there, which has been already been replied. So please do focus on that particular thing. And if you have a common problem and already question is there by some person, you just second him or her so that we can put all the answers together. Okay, so discussion forum is also useful for your the most important uses for content related queries, content related discussions, where the discussion thread will be there. Okay, now so use the discussion forum for the peer learning. We must learn from each other. Okay, this is very important because the course is very basic. From it's a for versatile learners. It is from basic to the advanced kind of content is there. So if you know the basics, please be with us and rather help the persons who don't know those kind of things. So it will be a peer learning and group learning. So actively participate in the forum. Now we'll move to the rest of the part. That is the main part, is some main FAQs we are going to take up. First thing is regarding the question that am I registered? Many learners ask the am I registered. Yes, if you are having the welcome note, if you are having the regular announcement in your email ID, in your register email ID, if you are getting the announcement, you are there in the course, you are registered. Second is the exam date. UGC MOOCs, the examination for the certification will be on the second Saturday and Sunday, there 8 to 9 November this year. And the centers will be there in the Pan India Examination Center. The National Testing Agency NTA will conduct these examinations, and by this date, on second Saturday Sunday of November, it is not going to clash with the NPTEL exams. Many of the learners are having the worries regarding that. Okay, yeah, mode will be online, and the online mode examination will be there. Exam form or exam registration link will be given to you at the September last week, and all will be duly informed regarding this thing. Okay, so don't worry. Next is the course. Till now, the courses UGC MOOCs are not FDP AICTE FDP approved or the equivalent to the refresher course till now, until unless we get the exclusive approval from authorities. These are the regular certificate courses. Okay. Foreign students, I welcome a large number of foreign students in our course. So for the examination kind of modalities, we are working on it, and soon we'll be addressing this you people exclusively. Okay. So meanwhile, you keep on learning. We welcome your active participation in the course. Thank you. So lastly, I would like to tell you two things. First, check your mails regularly for any update. Second, give your feedback about the course as and when required. And happy learning, continuous learning expected from you. Thank you.